A while ago, I uploaded a video comparing VMware to VirtualBox on Linux. On this and other videos, people commented that I should try Qemu or Qemu or however it's pronounced. So let's give it a shot. So what is it, you might ask? Well, it's an open source emulator that can emulate various architectures. However, using Qemu with KVM on an x86 board, it can be used essentially like VMware or VirtualBox, and many say it's faster than either of them. So let's take a look. There are various frontends that you can use with it, but I'll be using Virt Manager. Now, it's not the prettiest interface, but it works, and it has a lot of options. Once a VM is created, you can see here that you have everything from the basic config settings to doing more advanced things, such as device pass-through. For this video, I'm keeping it pretty simple, and for the video interface, I'm going to be using QXL. It just seems to run the best for me on this setup. Now, all tests will be run on fresh installs of Linux Mint 21.3, and I'm running this on the same hardware as last time. And each of the VMs, both on Qemu and VirtualBox, are set the same. 8 gigs of RAM with 4 threads. And the virtualized OS will be Windows 10. So, let's get into it. First, in Passmark, we can see that on the CPU test, it scored about 1,000 points higher than VirtualBox. Now, to put that into perspective, in past tests, VMware scored higher than Hyper-V, but only by a couple hundred points. So 1,000 points higher is a pretty big difference. In the memory test, Qemu still scored higher, but this time only by about 165 points. And in the disk benchmark, it actually scored less than VirtualBox by 198 points. In 7-Zip, Qemu again trounced VirtualBox by finishing about a minute and a half sooner. As usual, I ran Cinebench twice, and this first run was just single-threaded. VirtualBox took exactly 8 minutes longer to finish. That's a night and day difference. Remember, this is all running on the same hardware, and yes, both are using hardware virtualization. In the multi-threaded test, VirtualBox again lost to Qemu, completing the test over 2 minutes sooner. In Handbrake, as usual, no video acceleration was used. This is all CPU. Qemu again finished first, finishing 5 minutes sooner and averaging nearly 10 FPS faster. Now, I ran Ycruncher for the hell of it, and you can see the total calculation time shows Qemu finishing nearly 30 seconds sooner. As far as video performance is concerned, neither were great. As you can see here, both are dropping frames. However, Qemu is faring quite a bit better than VirtualBox. Now, you can get good graphics performance by passing through a spare GPU to the VM, but I'm not doing that here. This is just what they can do on their own. 2D isn't great, but it's watchable. 3D, however, well, neither Heaven or Tropics would even run on VirtualBox. So we'll compare Qemu against VMware. VMware's virtual 3D rendering is actually pretty impressive for what it is, but it's far from perfect. Qemu was consistent but slow, averaging around 2 FPS in both Tropics and Heaven, and VMware averaged about 29 FPS in Heaven. However, it did stutter and sometimes freeze. So VMware, huh? How does that compare against Qemu? Well, let's take a quick look. In 7-Zip, Qemu finished around a minute before either of the other two. And in the single-threaded Cinebench run, it again pulled ahead, finishing a little over 3 minutes before VMware. In the multi-threaded run, VMware caught up, but was still about 12 seconds slower than Qemu. And in Handbrake, Qemu pulled ahead again, but this time only by a few seconds. Now, VMware is known to be much faster on a Windows host than Linux, and all of these tests were done with a Linux host. However, it can still hold its own, at least until you compare it against Qemu. For raw computing power, Qemu with KVM is the way to go on a Linux system. Now here, you can see how close Qemu is to the bare host performance. For years, I've heard people talking about Qemu, but never really messed with it until now. I have used Proxmox on servers, which obviously also uses KVM, and really had good results. All the VMs always had great performance, and really, I take Proxmox any day over a Hyper-V server. So thank you guys for pushing me to try out Qemu. And again, I'm very impressed with the results. As always, if you're still watching, thank you. And let me know what you think down in the comments below. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.